What's up, guys? Robitech here in beautiful San Diego, California, and I wanted to do a video about beginning and getting into PC modding. Now, I know I'm a PC builder, but I'm not really a PC modder, and I wanted to talk to one of my best friends here, PC Works, about what it takes to get into this. So if you're interested, this is going to be a great video for you. What's up, buddy?
What's going on?
So this is the studio, huh?
This is the studio. This is where the magic happens.
How long have you been doing this all up?
Roughly about 4 years.
Okay, you're relatively new to the scene. 4 years isn't a ton of time.
Yeah.
What got you into it? Like, when you think about starting, what was the beginning of your journey?
The beginning of my journey was really me trying to do something for myself. You know, I kind of liked the industry. I wanted to like build a cool computer for myself. And then it kind of just spiraled into friends, family, and then the community.
If you want to start, what are some of the key tools, like the simple things to kind of start modding your own systems?
I would say some of the things that I would definitely get into as far as like the simple things, right? So I do a lot of pass-throughs. So it's very easy to make your system look clean, you know, routing tubes around the back, not having, you know, massive curves inside of your loops. M3, M4 tap, 632 tap, that would be something that, hey, you can make a quick panel, you tap a new hole, and then you make a new panel, you hide wires, make everything look nice and clean.
It sounds like getting into it is like understanding like the full fundamentals. So like, you know how to build a PC, you have built and have looped a PC before as well, right?
Yeah.
You're talking about tapping, then there's like the next step, which is like building panels and stuff for that. So tell me a little bit about, you got a couple big tools here. Which one would you choose and why?
This is my Omtec laser that I have. This is a 60 watt 20 by 28. I design panels on the computer and then I can just cut the panel out. It'll have the individual holes that I need already in there. This is kind of like a graduation level, maybe like you said, a step two.
Mm-hmm. What was like the ramping up to get to the point where you could do stuff like this?
So I guess for me at least, you had to like, I started working with a lot of brands. I started working with, you know, companies like Thermaltake and Intel, EK. And then once I saw a direction that I could go in that kind of made sense for me, then I was like, well, hey, I need to like invest in myself, invest in my business, and then take it kind of to this level.
What was the process like, and how long did it take you to just be able to do something successfully with it?
The learning curve is really, really easy for the laser. And the reason I tell people to go laser over CNC is because you just have a single axis. This is a Z. You're talking straight down. It's not X, Y, and back and forth. So it's very, very easy to learn the laser itself. This learning curve, I mean, maybe a couple weeks.
So that's actually pretty fast. And I think a lot of times when people see this stuff, they think, this is probably going to cost me $20,000 and I'm going to have to go get a college degree. But you actually did it in a couple weeks.
Yes.
And this system, it's like what, about 3K, right?
Yeah,
like three grand to get into it, right?
Yeah.
Which is not bad. Okay, so let's talk about this. It's a CNC machine, right?
Yeah.
So this one's a little bit more of a difficult thing to get into because now you have a Z axis as well as the as well as the X and Y axis.
Correct.
When would somebody need something like this?
If you guys are looking at like Mods by Bain, Snap Designs, like they do a lot of their own custom distros. They make their own custom cases and things of that sort. So this is what basically allows me to give that potential to do that.
This is a little bit more in depth, right?
Yeah, it's a little bit more in depth. So I would say like a couple of months after you learn it, it's pretty basic.
I think a lot of times when people see things like this, they just think industrial, therefore industrial price.
Yeah.
And I literally have to sell my house to get into it.
Yeah.
Okay, so how much does something like this cost?
So this one itself was $3,500.
Okay. What's up, guys? Robitech here. Quick interruption. Like and subscribe, but also let us know down in the comments, how can we make series like this better? We don't get a lot of opportunities to do this, and we want to make this more entertaining for you. Let's just kind of recap real quick, like what we've kind of gotten to, and you know, as you're kind of watching along. First, you have to have a pretty basic understanding of PC building, and you should also spend some time doing a couple loop systems.
Correct.
Friends and family are a great way to kind of start getting into that. Mm-hmm. Kind of advertising an offer up, places like that, to see if you can get into building. Then from there, we're talking about getting into then starting to do stuff like custom taps, stuff like that, which is like just getting some drill bits, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can upgrade to something like a laser.
Yep.
And then from a laser, we go to something like a CNC machine.
Correct. So like if you looked over at this system right here, you think about like, what can I do to make this look different, right? So, you know, with pulling the GPU out, there's a lot of random holes here.
Yep.
You know, and so for me, I would say, okay, let me measure this distance here, measure where the 24 pin comes in, and as well as the like type C cables and things of that sort. And like I would make a whole custom panel out of white acrylic with the pass with the cut through pass through holes for the cables, and then now you would have a cool clean.
And it just looks really, really, really clean.
Really clean.
And again, then, all that is for that is that's just using the laser.
That's just using the
and,
laser.
And basically a razor and a ruler.
Yeah. Exactly. And so you're making a square, you're making two small squares, you're cutting it, that'll cut it in maybe 30 seconds, and then boom, your system looks way cleaner.
Yeah. Okay, so that's a great example. Now let's talk about this, because this this is, you know, $5,000, right? Just in case stuff right here.
Uh-huh.
What does it take to get into this? Like, what are the modifications you're making to really kind of make something like this stand out?
This customer ordered a PSU that has a screen on it, right?
Right.
So he wants to be able to see a screen, but you won't be
Makes
able to
sense,
see
it. Yeah.
Right. So I'm gonna do a custom panel here that it'll allow him to see the screen here. Something like this, because of the case and how the case is actually designed, it's kind of already there for you when it comes to modding, but I will just add a couple of things in there just to make it look a little
bit cleaner. Now, last one, and then, you know, I feel like this is a good jump. What about 3D printers? Where do those, because like things like custom brackets, stuff like that, where does that kind of fit in?
That's probably the only place that I haven't gone yet. I think that would probably be like my next step.
Okay.
You know, between these two machines, they kind of keep me busy right now, but eventually.
Initially, you were just building PCs, and then afterwards, then you were doing custom water cooling, and then you were putting in taps, and then now you're using a laser, now you're using a CNC.
Yeah.
Next step, 3D printing your own cases, 3D printing accessories, all that sort of stuff ends up being the next kind of next kind of bit.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Super appreciate you taking the time to just kind of walk us through this. Any, like, if you were to give like a simple piece of advice to anybody here who's watching who's like, hey, I want to get into modding, what would that be?
Find somewhere, like some kind of outlet and direction that you can pay attention to that would give you like more creativity.
Who are some creators that, or YouTubers or whomever that you inspire you that you go and look at their builds?
I look a lot of Ben's builds.
Okay.
I have my friend Stuart, so GGF events. I look at a lot of his stuff. I think Snef does a great job on the builds that he does. You know, of course, John. You know, John has a real clean look to like the way that he does his builds. Of course, Ron. I mean, Ron can make anything look look amazing. You know, so, I mean, he could take a $50 case and make it look amazing. So that is our food, and that's our hunger, and like, we feed off each other. And like, how can we like keep one-upping the whole situation? So it's good.
Well, there you go, guys. So again, we'll have links to all of those guys down below if you want to check them out. So that way you can go and see the same people inspire Tim.
Yes.
Of course, you can also follow Tim. Where do they follow you? Like, if they want to find out more.
PC Works on Instagram, PC Works on TikTok, and then I have a YouTube channel, but I really don't use it.
It's not there yet, but soon. You have some good stuff, some good content coming out soon.
Sure.
Anyway, guys, this has been Roby Tech. I hope you've enjoyed this content. I'd love to know down in the description below, like other things that we can do when we find and work with people like Tim or John or whomever that you would love to see more content from, and what kind of questions you'd love us to ask, because then we can do follow-up things with them, because honestly, we work together all the time.
Yeah.
But anyway, guys, this has been Roby Tech. We hope you've enjoyed this episode, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.